It's good to see you today. Appreciate you tuning in for this look into God's Word. Come on with us to 1 Corinthians chapter 4. We're going to be looking at verses 6 through 17 today. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 6 through 17. Let's get over there. Let's read it together. Verse 6. Now these things, brethren, I have figuratively transferred to myself and Apollos for your sakes, that you may learn in us not to think beyond what is written, that none of you may be puffed up on behalf of one against the other. For who makes you differ from another? And what did you have? What do you have that you did not receive? Now, if you did not, grief, I don't think I can read today. Now, if you did indeed receive it, why do you boast as if you had not received it? You are already full. You are already rich. You have reigned as kings without us. And indeed, I could wish you did reign, that we also might reign with you. For I think that God has displayed us the apostles last, as men condemned to death, for we have been made a spectacle to the world, both to angels and to men. We are fools for Christ's sake, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are distinguished, but we are dishonored. To the present hour, we both hunger and thirst, and we are poorly clothed and beaten and homeless, and we labor, working with our own hands. Being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we endure. Being defamed, we entreat. We have been made as the filth of the world, the offscouring of all things until now. I do not write these things to shame you, but as my beloved children, I warn you. For though you might have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you do not have many fathers. For in Christ Jesus I have begotten you through the gospel. Therefore I urge you, imitate me. For this reason I have sent Timothy to you, who is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ, as I teach everywhere in every church. So, I said we were going to get through the chapter. So, today, have more of the body of the chapter. Last few days, we just been looking at it verse by verse. Okay. What was happening in Corinth, like I've mentioned before, they were discounting Paul, is what was happening. They did not like Paul for whatever reason. They didn't care for him. The more he loved them, the less he was loved. What he's doing here, there is a little bit of focusing. Paul, it's interesting, and I wasn't sure how to phrase this. I don't know of another way to phrase it than when you look at that verse and when he says, imitate me, verse 16. There is a focus. Paul is focusing on himself a little bit. Now, there's a reason that he's doing it, but this is what is happening. So, why focus on himself? One of the reasons is, by discounting Paul, they were actually discounting that which had been revealed and that which is written. Paul sowed it. He says, as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation. If you discount Paul, you are discounting his teaching. And that's what was happening in Corinth. You were starting to have false teachers. And those false teachers were a manifestation, frankly, of their attitude towards Paul and what Paul and how Paul had taught and preached. By discounting Paul, they were discounting the foundation, I would suggest, that Paul had laid down. That's what was happening. So that's how dangerous this is. So as he focuses on himself, to look at it, he's trying to get back down to the bedrock. They have not built the right way. He uses that figure of, you know, wood, hay, straw, gold, silver, precious stones. There was a lot of wood, hay, and straw there in Corinth. So what he's having to do as much as possible is he's trying to clear it back down, to the foundation, foundational matters, to the milk. By discounting Paul, that's what was happening. They were discounting that which was written, like we talked about the last couple days. There's something else here, though, that I think is interesting. How did they receive the gifts? Look at this passage again. Let me get it up a little bit higher. I had not considered before. When he talks about the gifts there in verse 7, "For who makes you differ from another? And what do you have that you did not receive? Now, if you did indeed receive it, why do you boast as if you had not received it? It's real easy to just look at that verse and say, well, God made them differ from another. Well, these things were received from God. It's real easy to say that, and I'm not saying they were gifts of the Holy Spirit. I recognize that. I understand that. What I would like for us to consider is, how were those gifts given? He made the point, and actually in the passage we read, you may have 10,000 instructors, but you only have one father, and he's using that analogy, and that's him. Here in Corinth, and this is what is so odd about Corinth, just how it is though, they were so proud of themselves, and they were zealous for the spiritual gifts. They were zealous. And they had a lot. They had the spiritual gifts. How did they have those spiritual gifts? How did those spiritual gifts come to them? Here are these people who are despising Paul, and they are not following Paul's example. So now Paul is pointing back to himself, and he has this discussion about the gifts. And he says in that passage, what do you have that you did not receive? Now, if you did indeed receive it, he wants them to go back to when they first received the gifts. Now, how did they first receive the gifts? It was through the laying on of the apostles' hands, and that's Paul. So you're going to discount Paul? You're going to discount Paul's teaching. You have all these gifts here that you're so proud of, and you're so proud of them, it's like you didn't get them by the grace of God. You got them by the grace of God, and whose hands did they come through? They came through Paul's hands. They didn't even come through Apollos' hands. See, he refocuses even more. Before he says, I figuratively transferred these things to myself and Apollos, but now he's not going to say, imitate me and Apollos. He's going to say, therefore imitate me. He's focusing on himself all of a sudden. And he's not taken away from the Lord. That's not what I'm saying. He's trying to get them to get back to the foundation that he laid down. How did they receive the gifts? Oh, you think you're so much better than Paul. You think that your teachers are so much better. You think that what you're teaching is so much better than what Paul taught. How did you receive those gifts? It was through the laying on of Paul's hands. They needed to remember that and not discount what Paul had taught, what was revealed through Paul. I wonder if that's what, not at least part of what is going on here in these verses. Because you have the contrast as well. In our verses, and they're from verse 8 on. Sarcasm, irony, I guess some people may think that it's, he's giving them an attaboy. These first four chapters, he's not real big on the attaboys. When he says, you are already full, you are already rich, you have reigned as kings without us, and indeed I wish you did reign. Especially look at verse 10, because I think verse 10 in my mind settles it. He says, you are distinguished. How were they distinguished? Just look at the contrasts, and there's an irony here. Oh, we are fools, but you are wise. He's already talked about the wisdom and how the problems that they had in the first chapter. We are weak, but you are strong. You are distinguished, but we are dishonored. We hunger and thirst. We're poorly clothed. We're beaten. We're homeless. You have this contrast going on. And I think Paul's point is similar to the point Jesus made about discipleship. It is enough that a disciple is like his master. At some point, here in Corinth, as Paul lays down this contrast, at some point, the disciples, and I'm not saying they were Pauline Christians. That's not what I'm saying. But Paul does say, imitate me. And they were not imitating him. Here he is, and you have this contrast repeatedly. As he says, wait a minute, we're fools, you're wise. We're weak, but you're strong. You're distinguished, but we're dishonored. We hunger and thirst. We're poorly clothed. We're beaten. We're homeless. In Corinth, he was with them with much concern. I can't remember the word that he uses. We labor working with our own hands. Being reviled, we bless. Who was reviling Paul? Remember what he said? It is a small thing that you judge me. Being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we endure. Being defamed, we entreat. We have been made as the filth of the world, the offscouring of all things. It's the contrast, is what it is. And for some reason, how can I say it? To look at the apostles and to look at the Corinthians. I'll get my hand over here. To look at the apostles and to look at the Corinthians. It was like looking at two different things. One was this way, one was the other way. It was contrast. They weren't the same. And a disciple should be like his master. Just as he's about to use the analogy of the father and the child, just like children should be like their parents. That's how it should be. So that's the contrast. This is why he is refocusing on himself, trying to get him to get back to as he followed Christ. God had displayed them. Did you notice that language? Let me get it up there. It says that God had displayed them. Uses that figure. Verse 9. I don't know why. Couldn't find it. Verse 9. For I think that God has displayed us, the apostles, last as men condemned to death, for we have been made a spectacle to the world. That word spectacle there, my Bible margin says that's the word theater. God had displayed them, the apostles, last, this way. Theater, spectacle. They needed to watch what was going on. They needed to watch. God has displayed. God is behind this. The focus is not meant to be. It's not meant to stop on Paul. They needed to see God's design in all this and see what God was doing. God has displayed. Had displayed the apostles, and made them a spectacle. The problem was people weren't watching. The Corinthians weren't watching. The Corinthians weren't following along with what was happening. They were too busy being proud of themselves to the point now where to compare the apostles with the Corinthians, it's like night and day. And in that, if they were not going to be like the apostles, then you can bet your bottom dollar they were not like Jesus. They were awfully proud of themselves, weren't they? They're high on the hog. They needed to stop. They needed to examine themselves. They needed to humble themselves. Paul's trying to get them back to that foundation, and he's getting them closer and closer to Jesus as he's pointing to himself and as God had used him. He's trying to get them to the designer, the justifier, the foundation. What was his faith built on? Jesus. I came and I preached the gospel, Jesus and him crucified. God had displayed them. Why do you display something? So that people can see it. So that people can follow along. Hope the study's been beneficial for you. Hope you have a good day. Appreciate you. Appreciate you following along. Appreciate you tuning in. Feel free to like, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff, whether you're watching on Facebook or on YouTube or on the church's website, whatever the case may be. Appreciate you tuning in. Hope to see you tomorrow. Thanks for being with us.